My name is Amon Mercier Chabert. I'm a lifelong resident of the city of Lowell. In fact, I was raised right down the street from here. And public safety was a concern then as it is now. There are a number of things we can do about it, but I'd like to address the forum's questions in it. Just very, don't forget, stop the clock. Just to answer these, because I think these are important to be answered. Recent policies surrounding sex offender access to the library, my position on that is they should not be allowed there, period. And if the Supreme Court rules, let them rule. We should not allow sex offenders in the library endangering our children. Muzzle policy on pit bulls, I think all pit bulls that are in their yard, in their house, are okay, but the minute they go outside that boundary, they should be muzzled. Curfew and policy for teens, I don't think a curfew works for teens, it doesn't work for anybody else. We've had that a number of years ago, and I don't know if it's still in place, but it's not enforceable. The best curfew we can have is directed to the parents, tell the parents to have a curfew for their kids and not the government. Expansion, contraction, law enforcement personnel. One of our biggest issues affecting public safety is the lack of police officers walking the streets and walking the neighborhoods. Of course, that boils down to the reason for that is the reason that we don't have enough money to support more personnel. So we should always pursue that because that is the best deterrent to crime is a police officer on the street. Any matter relating to public security is going to address? Yes, one of the things I want to mention, 60 seconds ago, I don't have any time, is the neighborhood groups, together with the parents, can bring about more safety than we have now if they collaborate together, like all of you have collaborated to bring this to the forefront. One of the things that I did when I was the head of the Housing Authority is we sought grants and received grants for special police to tour our housing projects. And that worked very well because the minute the housing project people knew that there were police in the neighborhood and they were walking there and it was visible, crime decreased tremendously. Unfortunately, we ran out of money and so we had to depend on the Lowell police to do it. And what we need to do is continue very, very aggressively find grants to put more policemen on the street, and that will make a big difference in public safety. As far as I'm concerned, that's one of the things that I've been pushing for the city council. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. First of all, I want to thank all of you for being here and attending this forum, and I also want to thank those who put this together. But I would hope that there's no perception here that public safety problems are just an acre problem, because it isn't. We just happen to be in the acre, and it happens to be the acre organization that has put forward the public safety issue. But it's a citywide issue and one that should be addressed by all of us at all times. When I was a city councilor, I was on the public safety committee, and I'm telling you that that was one of the best committees that the city could ever form, because those issues are real. They affect people real in a manner that it's not the way to live in the city of Lowell, this great city of ours. So I would hope that the city council, and I hope that I'm on the council at the time, continues the public safety issue and invites neighborhood groups to the meetings to tell us what your concerns are so we can do something about it. There are certain things we can't do, but believe me, there are certain things we can do if we put our mind to it. So it's my belief that public safety is a citywide issue and one should be addressed by the council at all times. And I would appreciate one of your nine votes. I'm in P. Mercier. I don't know what number I am on the ballot.